I welcome again to all of you to this video. In previous video, we were talking about relations, and in this video, we'll continue to talk about relations. All right. So in previous video, we had taken these two pictures, and we had talked about relations, right? Using this picture, we had talked about ordered pairs. I hope you remember that. And we had also talked about Cartesian product, which is this between two sets. And we had also defined relation as set A cross B. All right. So with this, let's move ahead to, you know, what are we going to cover in today's video? We'll be talking about different ways to describe a relation or to declare a relation, all right, or to define a relation. We will also talk about domain and range in a relation. We'll talk about inverse relation, empty relation, universal relation, identity relation, and we'll also talk about total number of possible relations that we can define between two sets. So without delay, let's begin. We can define or describe a relation in three ways. Let's take an example for quick understanding. All right. If there is a set A and B as given, all right. So I can directly define relation as set R using roster form or notation. All right. Or I can use set builder form or notation like this. All right. Or I can also use this kind of expression to define or declare my relation. So let's take one such declaration or description or definition and talk about it. This relation R consists of ordered pair A comma B, which are related like this. B is equal to 2A plus 1. All right. Where small a belongs to set A and small b belongs to set B. So what would these ordered pairs be? It would be 1 comma 3, 2 comma 5, 3 comma 7. So we can directly write those ordered pairs in this form, which is called roster form, or we can use set builder notation to define, describe, or declare a relation between set A and B. Or we can also use this method, this way, to declare a relation between set A and set B. A is related to B, and relation is being called as capital R if and only if B is equal to 2A plus 1, where A belongs to capital A, set A, and B belongs to capital B, set B. All right. There is another way to describe a relation. What they do is they use arrows. All right. So what they are doing is there is set A, there is set B. Set A has three elements, 1, 2, 3. And set B has four elements, 1, 3, 5, 7. And what they do is, what at times any author of a book does is, they'll say, okay, 1 is related to 3, and 2 is related to 5, and 3 is related to 7. And they use this kind of notation using arrows to describe a relation between set A and set B. So this is also used, but in general, this is avoided because this is not compact enough, right? So we use one of these three ways to describe a relation. All right, let's move ahead. Let's talk about domain and range of relation. Domain is set of all first entries of each ordered pair in a given relation. Like in ordered pair A comma B, all the values A, which is in first place of each ordered pair, will be part of my domain. Similarly, range is the second element of the ordered pair, all right, B. So second element of each ordered pair in a given relation is part of range. Let's take an example for quick understanding. All right. There is set A and there's set B. A consists of three elements, 1, 3, 5. B consists of three elements, 2, 4, 6. All right. Now, we have already declared a small a belongs to set A and small b belongs to set B. Okay, A is related to B if and only if A is less than B. Now here two relations I am talking about, so that I can take two examples based on same sets for better understanding. All right. So A should be less than B, so that A comma B is an acceptable ordered pair. Okay. So in this case, A belongs to set A and small b belongs to set B. So these six ordered pairs would be part of my relation or this relation set. All right. 1, 2, 1 is less than 2. 1, 4, 1 is less than 4. 1, 6, 1 is less than 6. Similarly, 3, 4, 3, 6, and 5, 6. All right. Here, my domain is 1, 3, and 5. Right? Abhi aisa nahi hai domain 1, 1, 1, 3, 3, 5. Actually, 1, 1, 1, they are all the same element. So 1 will come once, 3 will come once. All right. So since the first elements which are part of these ordered pairs are 1, 3, and 5. So this consists of my domain. And similarly, since 2, 4, and 6 are the second elements of ordered pairs in this set, which is the relation we are talking about. So all three of these elements will be part of my range. All right. Here we note that domain is same as set A and range is same as set B, but that's not necessary. All right, let's check this example. Here A is related to B if and only if B is double of A. All right, so this set R will be what? 1, 2 and 3, 6, right? There is no other ordered pair possible other than these two. All right, because A, small a, should belong to set A, small b should belong to set B. All right, so in this case domain is restricted to only two elements, 1 and 3, which are the first elements of the given two ordered pairs in the set R. Similarly, range also has just two elements, 2 and 6. All right, which are second elements of the ordered pairs in this set R. When a relation is defined from set A to set B, domain is going to be subset or equal set of set A, and range is going to be subset of set B, or range may also be equal to set B. All right, let's move ahead. Now here is a question. We have to write a relation on A defined as X R1 Y, X related to Y with relation R1, if and only if Y square equal to X. All right, where A belongs to this set. Okay, and we have been asked to do the same for the case X related to Y by relation R2 if and only if X square equal to Y. So let's do it. What will R1 be? R1 will have ordered pair. What will it be? It will be 1, 1, 1, minus 1, 4, 2, 4, minus 2. Right, because y square is equal to x. Now what is the domain here? Domain here is 1 and 4, and range here is 1, -1, 2, -2. Here we should understand that it is not given that x belongs to A, y belongs to A. So here there is one more takeaway. When there is an expression like relation on set A, that means we are talking about A cross A, where the first set is also A, the second set is also A. All right. So with this, you should be able to completely understand the relation R1. Now let's check out R2. In R2, what is the case? Here X square is equal to Y. So what will be the ordered pairs? 1, 1, -1, 1, 2, 4, -2, 4. All right. So domain in this case is 1, -1, 2, -2. And range in this case is 1 and 4. All right. Here one thing we notice that, you know, domain of R1 is range of R2 and domain of R2 is range of R1. For a swapping order, right? So R2 in one sense is inverse of R1. All right. So let's come to inverse relation. All right. R2 is inverse relation of relation R1. All right. So inverse relation R inverse. Agar main kahun, so how is it defined? Which is basically inverse of relation R. It is defined as all the ordered pairs B comma A, given that ordered pair A comma B belongs to relation R. So inverse relation R inverse is defined like this, which is by which we mean to say inverse of relation R. So here what will happen is range of R inverse will become domain of R, and domain of R inverse will become range of R. All right. Let's take an example for good understanding. All right. Say there is a set N which consists of first 10 natural numbers. All right. And we are defining a relation R where A is related to B if and only if A plus 2B is equal to 10, where small a also belongs to the set N and small b also belongs to the set N. So what will be the ordered pairs in this set capital R? 2, 4, 4, 3, 6, 2, 8, 1. What will be the inverse of this set R, which we are calling as R inverse? It is 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 6, 1, 8. Just swapping off, just as we have seen here. If A comma B belongs to R, B comma A belongs to R inverse. So 2, 4 belongs to R, 4, 2 would belong to R inverse. All right. Similarly, 3, 4, 2, 6, and 1, 8. So domain of R inverse is 4, 3, 2, 1, right? Which is range of R. And range of R inverse is 2, 4, 6, 8, which is domain of R. So R inverse in one sense can also be defined like A R inverse B if and only if 2A plus B equal to 10, where A and B belong to the set N. So this is a possible definition of R inverse. So you understand what an inverse relation mean. All right. So let's move ahead to other types of relations and other terms. All right. So there is something called empty relation, where an empty relation on any set, say set A, is when no element of A is related to any element of A. Let's take an example for understanding, right? There is a set A which consists of 4, 6, 8, and 10. And if there is a relation R, X is related to Y if and only if X and Y are relatively prime, where X and Y both belong to set A. So this is empty relation. Why? Because there is no ordered pair X comma Y possible which satisfies this condition, right? Because even if I take X comma Y to be the same element, then also they are not relatively prime, right? Because 4 and 4 is also not relatively prime. Their HCF is 4, not 1. All right. Anyway, what about universal relation? A universal relation on set A is when each element of set A is related to every element of set A. All right. So let's take an example. If A consists of 1, 3, 5, and 7, these are the elements of set A. And if relation is defined like this, that X related to Y if and only if X plus Y is even, where X and Y belong to the set A. All right. So here each element of set A is related to every other, not every, just other, even to itself. All right. Each element of set A is related to every element of set A. Even one is related to itself. 1, 1 is also one of the ordered pairs, right? Because 1 plus 1 is even. 1, 3, 1, 5, 1, 7, 3, 1, 3, 5, 3, 3, 3, 7. All possible ordered pairs are part of this relation. All right. So this is a universal relation on set A. I hope it's clear. Let's move to next type of relation, identity relation. A relation defined on set A is said to be an identity relation if each and every element of set A is related to itself and only to itself. All right, let's take an example. Okay, suppose there is a set N which consists of 5 elements, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, first 5 natural numbers. Now if small a belongs to this set N and small b belongs to this set N, and I describe a relation as A R1 B if and only if A equal to B. Now this is an identity relation because each element is related to itself and only to itself. All right, let's consider these other relations or other sets on set N only. We are talking on set N only. So let's consider this R2, which consists of 3 ordered pairs, 2, 2, 3, 3, 5, 5. Is it an identity relation? No. Why? Because each and every element of set A is related to itself and only to itself. Each and every. All right. Here we are missing 1, 1 and 5 and 4, 4. All right. Now this R2 can be defined like, you know, A R2 B if and only if A equal to B and A is a prime number. So we'll get R2 set of ordered pairs. But here it is not an identity relation on set N. Why? Because 1, 1 and 4, 4 are missing. All right. So what about this set R3? 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 5, 5, 1, 2. It is also not an identity relation. Why? Because this ordered pair is coming extra. Every element of set A is related to itself and only to itself. All right, so here 1, 2, since this ordered pair is part of R3, R3 is not an identity relation on set N. I hope it's clear. Now coming to the last thing of this video, number of relations that can be defined from set A to set B is equal to number of possible subsets of A cross B. All right, of the Cartesian product A cross B. Say there is a number of elements in set A is P and number of elements in set B is Q. What will be the number of elements in set A cross B? By which I mean, what would be the number of elements in the Cartesian product of sets A and B? It will be PQ, which we have seen in previous session or previous video, which you can refer. All right. So how many number of relations are possible which can be defined from set A to set B? It is as many the number of subsets possible of this set A cross B, of the set which is Cartesian product between set A and set B. So how many number of relations are possible? It is PQC0 plus PQC1 plus PQC2 plus so and so forth plus PQCPQ, which is equal to 2 to the power PQ. Now how to understand this? There are PQ elements in set A cross B. Now out of those PQ elements, I can have 0 element in my relation or 1 element in my relation or 2 elements in my relation, so and so forth. I can have even all PQ elements in my relation. So the total number of relations possible is PQC0 plus PQC1 plus PQC2 plus so and so forth plus PQCPQ, which is equal to 2 to the power PQ. All right. Now we can understand it in other way also. All right. Each element of Cartesian product A cross B can be part of the relation or may not be even part of the relation. So first element can be part of the relation or may not be part of the relation. All right. So there are two ways in which the first element can be considered. Similarly, second element may be part of the relation, may not be part of the relation. So again, two ways related to the second element. Similarly, two ways related to each of these PQ elements, right? So 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by up to PQ times, right? So it becomes 2 to the power PQ. All right. Just let me take an example in case it is required. Say there are there is a set A, which is 1, 2, 3. All right. And there is a set B, which is 4, 5, 6, 7. All right. So number of elements in set A is 3. Number of elements in set B is 4. So number of elements in the Cartesian product of set A and B would be what? 3 into 4, which is 12. So number of relations possible from set A to set B would be what? Based on what we have just learned, it would be 2 to the power 12. That's it. So I hope it was beneficial video to you all. I thank you, each one of you, for your attention, for your patience, and for your keen interest. Thank you. Have a nice day. Goodbye.